hey guys, what's going on? So you've crunched the numbers, you've gone through the budget, and you realize you can't afford that CNC. Congratulations, you're absolutely gonna love it. One word of warning though, something that I didn't know, something that I wish I knew when I bought my CNC, were all the, I don't wanna call them hidden costs, but all the costs that are gonna pop up along the way that you're gonna need to probably buy. Hopefully a couple of these you don't have to buy, but I figured I would walk through a list of everything that popped up on me throughout my first year and what those cost me. And then at the end of the video, I will give you a grand total, and then that can maybe help you decide if this is right for you. All right, the first and most obvious cost is the CNC itself. I bought a Onefinity, and at the time, it cost me $1,995. When you're shopping around the site, you can add on certain accessories. So at the time, I did want pretty much all the bells and whistles, so I added on almost everything that they had. I bought a touch probe, that was $88. I bought a wireless controller for $41. I bought a dust boot, which then I've had to replace since then, but that was $90. And then I bought the JTEC laser add-on. It comes with everything you need to be able to run a 7-watt laser. And I think now they're actually 14 watts, so you're getting even more bang for your buck there. But the grand total between the machine and all those accessories was $3,162. So while it's sitting in your cart at just under $2,000, that definitely looks a little bit easier to swallow than $3,162. But I figured if I was gonna get this, might as well get all the bells and whistles so I'm ready to go. So that's what I ended up doing. After I added all this to my cart and I checked out, I started to run through the checklist of what I figured I would need. First thing I would need would be some sort of computer or laptop, MacBook, that I can actually run my CNC with, something that I can set all my files in, do all my manipulation, do my rendering, and then save all my G-code. I was using a desktop, but that was down in the basement. I didn't feel like always going down into the basement, and it was a little bit on the old side, so I wanted to get a laptop. I ended up going with a gaming laptop. I figured that would have plenty of computing power to be able to do any of the 3D renderings, save the G-code. I could be in Internet Explorer, checking out files, minimize that, go into Inkscape, mess around with the file in there, go back to Internet Explorer, pull up Easel. So I wanted something that had plenty of computing power. So I went with a gaming laptop, and that cost me $1,440. Now I just needed a program. The most obvious and easiest thing for me was to just use Easel, the free version. You can actually do quite a bit with that. Once you decide you wanted to do some more features, such as VCarve, and you wanted to use the Pro Design library and add different text and different fonts in your program, you do need to upgrade to Easel Pro. At the time, it was a little bit cheaper, but right now, you can get Easel Pro for $24 a month. And if you buy a full year subscription, that's $234. I know there are other programs out there that you can use a one-time purchase and then it's yours for your entire life. So that's something that I probably will upgrade very soon. I think I've got about 4 months left on my Easel purchase. I bought the year just to save the money. Pretty much the beginning of fall, call it September, I'm gonna be shopping around, weighing my options, trying to figure out what to do. I would love to get something that maybe has a little bit more features, maybe something that I can get in about $200 to $300 one-time purchase, and then it's mine and then I don't have to worry about it anymore. Now it's time to do a little workout here in the shop. You need a stable base that you can set your CNC on, something that isn't gonna change with the temperature, the humidity, and something that will stay completely stable so that your CNC can run to maximum efficiency. I decided to go with an entire enclosure here. I've got the wood, I've got an acrylic panel, I've got rubber soundproofing on the inside, some LED strip lights. I've got drawers. I've got all kinds of goodies with this thing. I decided that I wanted a full-on enclosure for a couple reasons. Number one, to keep the sound down as much as possible so my neighbors wouldn't hate me. And for the second reason, I wanted to keep all the dust contained. While shooting YouTube videos, I typically don't use the dust boot, so it will shoot dust all over the place. So I figured if I had it contained at least somewhat, that would help with the dust control. All in all, after I purchased the wood, the MDF surface, my MDF spoil board, T-track, rubber, lights, drawer runners, all that good stuff, I am in for about $800. The next thing to think about are bits. I ended up buying an Amana Tools starter kit. I believe it came with 7 or 8 bits. Some of them I haven't used yet, and some of them I've used so much that I've had to replace. But you can start with these starter sets. It cost me about $200, and then I've had to buy bits since then. I've had to buy 1/8 inch, 1/16 inch, and even 1/4 inch bits to replace because I've used them up so much. You can tell when you're starting to use them up so much, they kind of get a higher pitched squeal to them. And then of course you've got all the ones that you break along the way that you need to replace. But each time you're doing that, that bit's costing you 35, possibly 40 bucks per shot. You're at the point now, you're making dust. Now you need to do something about that dust. I bought myself a shop vac. That cost me about 90 bucks. The way I have it in the back bottom corner of my enclosure here, I didn't want to have to reach in there and pull it out, disconnect hoses every single time. So I bought a dust deputy, and what that will do, that will take out all of the larger pieces and even quite a bit of the small dust, and it will separate it into a 5-gallon bucket first. Then that way, in order to empty all that out, all you have to do is pull that lid off, take the bucket out, empty it, and put it back in. This does two things. Number one, it makes emptying that bucket quick and easy. But number two, it keeps all that dust from bogging down your shop vac filter. So that motor is going to run at 100% peak efficiency forever. I mean, really, you're not bogging it down, so you're not shortening the life of that. But number two, since that filter is always staying clean, you're getting full horsepower. And that's exactly what you want. So I definitely highly recommend a dust deputy cyclone. So you've got your bits, you've got your dust control. Now you need something to spin those bits. I went with the Makita palm router. That seems to be the cheapest entry level choice. I've had this thing running for a year now. I haven't had any problems yet. I did buy a set of replacement brushes. That way, in case this thing does happen to go down right in the middle of a project, I can replace those brushes. They were only, I think, like 15 bucks for a set of two. But the other option you can go with is a water-cooled spindle. I think that's if you're running more production or you're running a larger scale business. You can run that spindle faster and harder, and it's going to last longer too. And I think they're actually a little bit quieter. So that's an option. But for 100 bucks, I got this Makita router. One thing that I haven't done yet that I want to do is I want to upgrade the touchscreen monitor that comes with the Onefinity. When I bought mine, they were offering just a 7-inch screen. And then, of course, 1 month after I received mine, they came out with a 10-inch screen. If you go to the Onefinity forum and you scroll down on the page, you'll see a section for monitors. And it's people who have bought larger monitors, like 15.6-inch on up, maybe even 20-inch. And if these monitors did work for them or didn't, they'll put the name down there and a brief description of how it worked and if it worked, and then they'll give you a link too, so you can upgrade your monitor to something larger, a little bit easier to read. Okay, so as I start putting all these numbers right here, things start to add up. You can see it's a far cry from 1995. Wait a minute, did I just become super hot all of a sudden? Not the year 1995, I'm talking about $1,995. So keep that in mind, guys. This is the rough number that you're gonna end up spending to get this thing running. This can vary though, obviously, if you decide to upgrade the monitor, or you go from a router to a spindle, or hopefully you already have some sort of desktop or PC that you can run all your files on, and that'll save you a large chunk of money as well. And again, this is your rough number, guys. It's gonna change a little bit. If you upgrade the monitor, that's gonna add some cost to this. If you have a laptop or a desktop or MacBook, that then will decrease this number quite a bit. So that'll help you out a lot. If you decide to go down this route, just remember, you don't have to get everything right now. You can space it out over a couple of months or half a year, what have you. That way the number doesn't hurt so bad, but I hope this video helps you guys out. I hope it opens your eyes to a couple of things that I know I didn't know. If you guys like this video, please give me a thumbs up and a subscribe. Maybe even drop a comment down below. Let me know what you think. Did you upgrade to a spindle and do you like it better? Or did you upgrade your monitor and which one did you go to? So until next time, take it easy.